Hello students, good morning. I have given you a small assignment, homework, and I think you will be able to manage it. Aap kar sakenge, and I want to see whether you are able to understand me or not. And what I have taught so far, I am giving you some sentences, simple sentences. We have done noun, we have done the pronouns, and we have done the verbs. I will also explain to you the various kinds of noun, and as the first topic is we are discussing the sentence patterns and the construction of sentences. I want you to make some sentences using the words. Pehla sentence, the children are studying in the dash. You have to put a proper, you have a noun here. So noun ka istamal karke ek shabd dalenge aap. Second, dash by vegetables, put a pronoun. Third, we dash hard to get good marks. Put a proper verb here. Fourth, the world is dash a pandemic. Aapko verb dalna hai. The college dash is empty. College, you see there is an apostrophe s, and you have to put a possessive noun here. All right, think about it and put a proper possessive noun. Next one, they healed. You have to put a reflexive pronoun. They healed dash. Seventh, the boys are having dash. Uncountable noun you have to put. Uncountable, remember, not countable. Uncountable is something which you cannot count. All right, dash is a strength. Now you have to put an abstract noun here. Ninth, dash is coming, and there is only one indefinite pronoun in English language. You have to put that. Dash is coming. And the last one, she dash fruit from the market. And you have to put a verb here. Then you have to make sentences. I'm sorry, I got a little confused with the ninth sentence. Dash is coming. I said you have to put an indefinite pronoun. There are four or five various kinds of, as I say, somebody, anybody, nobody. All these are indefinite pronouns. You have to put a proper indefinite pronoun, and there is only one impersonal pronoun in English, and that is it. All right, always remember that. And then you have to make some sentences here. One sentence banayenge, proper noun, one of countable noun, personal pronoun, impersonal pronoun, and irregular verbs. All right. So you have 10 marks each and 10 marks each. 10 sentences, you have 10 marks. And this is again 2 marks each, one sentence, or 20 marks paper. Okay? Try it and do it, and all the best. Thank you. I am Dr. Madhuri Chatterjee giving you the assignment.